Today is a day of commemoration and reflection for Europeans. We are marking the 70th anniversary of the Schuman Declaration, delivered by France's then Foreign Minister Robert Schuman in the Salon de l'Horloge at the Quai d'Orsay in Paris. This declaration is considered the founding document in the building of a united Europe. What Europeans are celebrating today is the extraordinary result of an adventure unique in human history, the resolve expressed by all nations to share sovereignty in order to never again experience the wars that had darkened the European continent. The goal has been achieved, but we also learned over the years that in order to endure in the long run, this project of reconciliation had to extend throughout successful and successive enlargements. It had to take root in a variety of economic areas, hence the large internal market, cohesion funds, and the single currency. And most important, it had to be defined through core values, the commitment by members of our European family to democracy and solidarity. The crisis we are currently experiencing, unprecedented in the harshness of its impacts, confirms the importance of those values to the survival and perpetuation of our European dream. In the words of Jean Monnet, Europe will be forged in crisis and will be the sum of the solutions adopted for those crises. Yes, we have witnessed European solidarity, often delayed and still imperfect, but real nevertheless. Toward Europeans stranded abroad when borders were closed, toward citizens threatened with unemployment, toward patients who were taken in by neighboring countries when there were no hospital beds available at home, toward nations that were hit harder than others through the creation of powerful financial instruments already decided upon and in the process of negotiation. Toward the neighbors of the EU and the most vulnerable countries through initiatives with our African partners and global health actors to provide access to diagnostic testing, treatments, and vaccines. Solidarity, together with international cooperation, is in fact the best guarantee of effectiveness in dealing with such crises, for we will only overcome them together. This is the message that Europeans are spreading worldwide, first and foremost, of course, with our American partner, with whom we share a commitment to the same values. The success of European integration, which has enjoyed US support from the very beginning, is more necessary than ever to the security and prosperity of our American ally. In a world where our shared values are increasingly contested and where the dangers we face are increasingly large, it is therefore particularly important that we, Europeans, the European embassies coordinated by the European Union delegation, celebrate this anniversary today here in Washington, centered around the notion of solidarity, proclaimed loud and clear in the midst of this pandemic, standing side by side with health professionals and those of other occupations who often put their own lives at risk in both the US and Europe to protect our fellow citizens. It gives us great pride to show that here on American soil, European citizens and businesses are actively taking part in this great movement of solidarity. Long live Europe, and long live the friendship between the United States and Europe.